Hello, my name is B.D. Frank, and I'm doing this video, which I'm going to call an instructional or informational video, not a review, of a recent purchase of a Republic Resonator guitar, Highway 61 model. Model 7208, it's the shorty or the short scale neck in red copper rust. And the reason I purchased this guitar, I've got a lot of national Resonator guitars, and I wanted a small, short guitar that I could travel with, and this seemed to fit the bill. I did a lot of research, looked at a lot of reviews online, and this seemed to be the best of the, quote, cheap guitars or cheaper guitars. So first thing I'm going to do is just take a look at the guitar and show you the guitar. First impressions are it's a pretty nice looking guitar. It's not a national, but then again, it doesn't cost what a national costs. So keeping in mind the price point of the instrument. A little bit sloppy on their faux finish there, a little bit sloppy on the rust, and let's see, not the nuts a little bit off. I don't know if you can see that or not. A little offset. And some, you probably can't see this, but there's some spurs, wood spurs left from the drilling and milling of the headstock there. So it doesn't have the care that perhaps a national would have, but it is what it is. Now, I've done a fair amount of reading, and a lot of people like to change out the cones in these guitars, and I just happen to have a National hot rod cone laying around, so I think I'm going to give it a try. Now, before I pull the guitar apart, it's only fair to have a discussion of sound and what this thing sounds like. And remember, I'm used to Nationals, so it's definitely a little bit different. Now, first impressions for me, a little duller sounding than the Nationals, not much on the high end, kind of heavy, lower mid-range sound to it, not very crispy, but it's a metal guitar, what do you expect? Sounds like a metal guitar sounds, and we'll see if changing out the cone is going to have any difference, make any difference in sound, have any difference to the tonal qualities of this instrument. And this is something that's not very difficult to do. I own 7 Resonator guitars, Resonator mandolin, and a Resonator tenor guitar. So I work on all my instruments, and I'm kind of used to taking these things apart. But it's really not that hard. It's not that intimidating to do, especially on the lesser expensive guitar. So we're going to start digging into this, and maybe you'll get a few hints, maybe you'll yell at me, I'm not sure which one it'll be, but I'm not going to leave a contact number, so if you want to yell at me, you'll have to do it in silence. Okay, here we go. Now, typically I would pull the strings off and just replace the strings, but for the sake of comparison and for me hearing the cones, I want to keep the same strings on there. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a little piece of tape across the bridge to hold the strings in their slots there, loosen the strings, and remove the tail piece. Incidentally, the guitar was tuned to an open A. Just want to mention with the 3/4 scale guitars, there's a lot less tension, so they tend to be better in tight open tunings or higher open tunings. So A is the one I chose. And now I'm pulling off the tailpiece here, just unscrewing the screw in the end. Okay. All right, now I'm just going to lift the tailpiece right off there. So now I've got the strings and all. And when I pull the cover plate off, I should be able to feed that through without too much trouble. What I like to do, we'll see, being a new guitar, I haven't had a new guitar to work on before. So what I usually do in the older guitars is I like to find a screw bit that fits very well, and then I like to put either vice grips or pliers or something so I can put downward pressure when I'm screwing, unscrewing these. But wow, seeing that it's new, this is a luxury for me. I believe, I may be wrong, but I believe they are brass screws. At least they look like they're brass, and if they are, you have to be careful. Brass is a very, very soft material and very easy to strip out. So we'll be real careful pulling these babies out. There's nothing worse than stripping out a screw that's a cosmetic finish on your instrument. So we don't want to do that. Now, it should go without saying, but I'm going to say it anyway. There's nothing like a nice cup to put all your screws in. Have them all in the same spot. And they don't fall off the table. You can spend an hour looking for one of these screws on the floor. Okay, I've got all the screws out. I'm going to carefully pull the plate up. Okay, and I'm going to fold my tape around here to keep my strings in. And let's see if we can carefully feed our bridge through the plate, our tailpiece through the plate. Okay, we're leaving the plate on. Okay, so there's our cone. My understanding is these cones are Continental cones. I've got my hot rod cone here, same size. I think it's 9.5 or somewhere in that vicinity. And there's all sorts of rumors about these Continental cones being clunkers compared to the National hot rod cones, and we're going to find out. Okay, so here's our cone. I'm going to remove the biscuit from the cone. Before I proceed any further, I'm going to take this opportunity to inspect the guitar and see what we got here. First thing I notice that under the tailpiece is must be some kind of acoustical masking tape. And as you know, that's a joke. So that gives you an idea of the how careful these things are put together, that we use masking tape in the process. A little ridiculous. Interior, brass. Let's look at the welds. I'm just kind of looking around. Don't know if you can see them or not, but the welds are visible, and they look okay. Not as clean as a National, but not bad. Now, I also want to point out here, my biscuit's a little bit of a mess here, too. I don't know if you can see that. It's just kind of looks like a chunk of wood somebody carved off a tree and put some slots in every here and there just for fun. Pretty poor excuse for a biscuit. But anyway, let's move on. Also, I noticed there's a little tab here on the back. Don't usually find that on Nationals. So let's go ahead and unscrew it. Now, a properly installed biscuit, at least per National specs, should be glued to the cone with just a little bit of wood glue. Obviously, that's not the case here. No wood glue. Okay, so now we've got our two cones. And just for the heck of it, I think we need to do a little test here. This is kind of an interesting thing. I did see somebody online do, just to get an idea what these things ring or don't ring like. Wee bit clunky. Let's see what the National spun cone does. That one's got a little sustain, little ring to it. Don't know if you can if you can hear that little ring. Let's go back to the Continental cone here. Got a little ring to it too, but it seems to be definitely a different pitch. National is a little bit deeper and seems to ring a little bit longer. Now the Continental cone too also looks like it's been a little, I don't want to say damaged, but kind of reamed out a little bit further than need be. Maybe that's why it had the little piece of plexiglass tab on the bottom, but I can't help but think that must have some minor effect on sound tone. Okay, per National specifications, National guitar specifications, I'm going to put just a little bit of wood glue just around the rim here, just to help make a nice tight solid fit contact with the cone. Needless to say, I'm also going to leave the handy dandy shim out. And we'll see if that'll work. Hopefully I don't find out that there's a reason why the shim was in there. Something to do with the biscuit, but I don't think I will. I think it had to do with the hole being too big. Somebody screwed it in too hard in the other one, I'm guessing. There we go. Alright, so I want this snug, but not tight to the point that it puts a hole through the cone like the other cone. Usually with the Nationals, I'll go until there's just a little dimple in there, just holding it in place. I'm going to give it just a hair more snug there. Go with that. There we go. And I'm going to take a little bit of water and wipe the excess wood glue off. It's one of the nice things about the wood glue is that while it's wet, it is water soluble, so it just comes right off. And there we go, that's the installation of my new biscuit, my new cone. Now total time to do something like this, change this out, would be in the vicinity of an hour or so. And you know, take your time. I always try to take my time. I just got myself a cup of coffee and just kind of go slow and easy. No sense in rushing and ruining something. And it could probably be done quicker, but hour's good with me. Take my time. Okay, get my strings lined up. Close anyway on the bridge there. Let's get our tailpiece. Now there's so many notches in this biscuit, we're just gonna have to hope for the best, see if we're on the right ones. Who knows? We will find out. Okay, that's pretty good. That looks pretty good. Go ahead and push our bridge into place. Checking the nut here, feels like the nut's glued on. I don't like it when the nut's glued on. Often I like to lift the nuts a little higher for slide, but obviously this one is going to need a little work. And I'll probably have this guitar part again sometime in the future. The objective right now is do the cone swap, and that's what I'm doing. All right, so let's get our tailpiece lined up. Screw back in place. cup. Well, there it is. There goes my hour. First modification. Screw that was in there. Doesn't grab, doesn't fit anything. Bent. So my opinion of quality of workmanship is going down quickly. So let's go ahead and do that. There we go. That doesn't look too bad. Black sheetrock screw. That'll do for now. All right. Now we're ready to place the strings where they belong and tighten her back up and see what the possibility is of the new cone. You ask yourself, how can that happen? Stupidity runs rampant in my world. Okay, so we're going to pull the tape off here now. We shouldn't need that anymore. All right, go ahead and put the screws back in. And that's a sign of confidence. That's a sign that this will indeed work. Get that plate just right. Try that, see if that does it. Now another tip with these screws, being someone that's put in probably hundreds of these, I never tighten them up until I have them all in place, because sometimes on the older guitars that I've had, they're just a little bit out, and if you don't tighten them up, it leaves you just enough room to shuffle them in there. And I'm not over tightening again, because once again, brass, soft metal. So we put these in. And another thing to keep in mind, anybody that's done enough of this has found out the hard way that the screws do fit through the holes here in the cover plate. And there's nothing worse than being on your last screw and then you drop one in the cone, because I'll tell you what, it goes in there real easy, but it won't come out. I've shaped him for 15, 20 minutes trying to get him out, and you're doomed. You just gotta go ahead and pull it off and start again. Okay, we got our screws all in place. Get them tightened nicely. I left my factory masking tape under the tailpiece to keep it from rattling. Nationals have a piece of felt under there. I'll probably take this apart in the future, I'm sure, and treat it a little nicer. As I say, the intention right now here is just to get the cone switched out and see what we sound like. Okay, I'm going to tune this baby up now. Okay, here we are completed. Sits a little higher. I don't mind. Most of what I do is slide, 99%. As I said, in the future I'll go back and fit the nut so it's not sticking out on the sides there. That's annoying. It's kind of annoying. And raise it up a hair and set it up for better slide playing. So there you go. There's changing out a cone. And if you watch this video and you come away with one thing, it's don't be afraid to take your resonator apart, especially a newer one like that. Does it sound any better? Any different? It's the first time I've picked it up with the cone in there, so you're finding out with me. Does sound a little bit brighter. has a little bit more kick in that upper mid-range. A little bit more in the bottom there too. So there you go. Changing out a cone on a Republic Highway 61. Almost forgot what it was. Thank you. Okay, now that I've had the opportunity to play around with the guitar a little bit more, I'm gonna say the difference is 100% difference. Now, I did find some problems when I took it apart. That little fiberglass disc that was on the underside of the cone, not glued to the cone, not secured to the cone. So the reasons it sounds better could be, in my estimation, a combination of everything.